What's up, tired mamas? It's Melissa here with The Cradle Coach, and we're talking sleep regressions with your two-year-old. This regression is more challenging because of the nap battles. So get ready. We're gonna teach you everything you need to know in order to help your child get through this regression and give them the sleep they need. When it comes to the two-year sleep regression, the biggest tip I can tell you is to focus your attention on the naps. Many times, the naps are the biggest trouble that you're gonna find during this regression. The nighttime sleep and the early morning wake-ups might occur, but it's really due to the lack of nap that is happening so that they're not getting that restorative sleep. Their body is saying, hey, wait, let's pump some adrenaline here. They start to go down for their nighttime sleep and they just battle it out, not ready to fall asleep. And that same thing occurs in the morning, so where they start to wake up earlier and earlier and the nap gets shifted. Sometimes this is when parents drop their naps altogether. We don't want that. We want to make sure that your child is getting the best sleep possible and the most amount of sleep, even if it looks like they're not wanting the nap. Try and test the nap out for at least a month. That is what we always tell our clients. Go in and make sure you have your sleep training technique, your set routine, and follow through with the sleep training technique for up to a month, especially at the two-year stage, because 9 times out of 10, they want to drop that nap because they're excited. They want to play. They want to enjoy their morning and their day, and they don't want to be stopped by a boring nap. So be sure that you're really preserving this sleep as long as you possibly can. We often don't see naps completely dropped until about 3 or 4 years old. So during this regression, when many parents start to drop the nap, the nighttime sleep gets to be a battle and the early morning wake-ups start to be occurring. So go back to that nap and make sure that you're really allowing your child to get the best sleep possible during that time. And if you have to reduce the nap at this point, it's okay. Sometimes 2 hours is too much and their bedtime routine becomes a little bit more dragged out. We wanna make sure they're getting a nighttime sleep that's full and restorative. But that means that we might have to reduce our nap during the day by a little bit, maybe every 15 minutes, every 3 days, to see what's working and what's not. So before you reduce the nap altogether, go back to giving them the nap and making sure you reduce the amount of time your child is given that nap. Don't get rid of it. They will battle you here and they will test you, but check out their behavior to make sure if they're really reducing the nap or the nap is just going through a little bit of a regression when they need your help for. So we wanna hear from you. So comment down below. We wanna know if your child went through a sleep regression. If so, which one was the hardest and how did you handle it? And don't forget to check out thecradlecoach.com for more sleep tips. We wish you nothing but the sweetest dreams.